Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the development of the vertebral column. First, we're going to look at the different parts of the vertebrae that need to develop, and then we're going to see how that happens. The vertebral column is formed by a series of bones called vertebrae, which start beneath the cranium and go all the way up to the tip of the coccyx. They are divided into regions. From top down, the cervical vertebrae, the thoracic vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae, the sacral, and the coccygeal vertebrae. This is the adult column where the sacral vertebrae and the coccygeal vertebrae are fused, forming single bones. But they start off as separate bones and only fuse much later in life. Now, all of these vertebrae have differences between them based on the region we're looking at. For example, thoracic vertebrae are attached to ribs, so that will make them look different. But most of them follow the template of a typical vertebra. If we assume this is a typical vertebra and we're looking at it from above, this is anterior and this is posterior. The vertebral body is anterior and the vertebral arch is posterior. The two are connected by pedicles, which continue as sheets of bone called laminae. At the junction of two laminae is the spinous process extending posteriorly. Extending on either side are transverse processes, and extending above and below are articular processes, which we can see better from the side. So these are the superior and inferior articular processes, which articulate with the processes on the vertebra above and below them. The vertebral bodies have a smooth rim. Between the bodies of the vertebrae is an intervertebral joint with the intervertebral disc. The disc has concentric layers of fibrocartilage called the annulus fibrosus and a central gelatinous nucleus pulposus. Between the body and the arch is a space called the vertebral foramen. All these spaces line up, forming the vertebral canal, which has the spinal cord. And from that spinal cord, spinal nerves emerge, which pass through the intervertebral foramina on the sides formed by those articular processes. So we know what needs to develop, and now we'll go back and see how we get here. I'm going to start off a little schematically. We'll start with the three germ layers which form all the structures in the body, the ectoderm, the mesoderm, and the endoderm. For this, we need the mesoderm. The mesoderm forms three parts, the paraxial mesoderm, the intermediate mesoderm, and the lateral plate mesoderm. We only need the paraxial now. The paraxial mesoderm is going to form structures called somites, which are little segments all along the sides of the notochord. On the dorsal surface of the embryo, there are around 44 to 45 somites. Each somite has three parts, the dermatome, the myotome, and the sclerotome. Sometimes these two are clubbed together as dermatomyotomes, but we need the sclerotomes. The sclerotomes of the somites are what form the vertebrae. And now we're going to see what happens to them. This is part of the transverse section of the embryo when the vertebrae are going to develop. And this is the part that we need. There's the neural tube, which is going to form the spinal cord. This is the notochord. And then we have the body wall. Towards the body wall are myotomes, which are going to form muscles. Myo is muscle. And all of this is mesenchyme. Every bone has to go through stages of development. Here for the vertebrae, there is the mesenchymal stage, the cartilage stage, and then the bone stage. During the bone stage, first primary ossification centers form, and then secondary ossification centers form. Now, all of this doesn't happen during the embryo stage. It's a much longer process because these secondary centers only appear at puberty. That's how bones are. The process that starts in the embryo goes on until middle and late life. But we start with the mesenchymal stage, also called the precartilaginous stage. The mesenchyme condenses in three parts, around the notochord, around the neural tube, and there's that mesenchyme from the body wall. Eventually, they'll form that vertebra, but to get there, we need to take it part by part. So that's three areas of mesenchymal condensation, around the notochord, around the neural tube, and the mesenchyme from the body wall. Now we'll take a section through the notochord part. So we have the notochord in the center, surrounded by that mesenchyme, the body wall, and the myotomes. So each of these is a somite. And though it would be easier to learn if one somite formed one vertebra, it's not that simple. Embryology is always like that. Each somite is a segment, and each one gets divided into a cranial part and a caudal part. The cranial part has loosely condensed mesenchyme, and the caudal part has densely condensed mesenchyme. Some of the denser cells migrate and condense between the two halves. Now the denser caudal portion fuses with the looser cranial portion of the next somite. And that happens throughout the column. The somites are segments, and they're getting reorganized. Now these structures are between the myotomes. They're becoming intersegmental. These are forming most of the vertebral bodies. This part of the vertebral body is called the centrum. The migrated portion in the center forms the intervertebral disc, the annulus fibrosus. The notochord disappears in between the newly forming vertebral bodies. The remnant of the notochord in the intervertebral disc expands and forms the gelatinous nucleus pulposus. This process was resegmentation, and the centrum is thus an intersegmental structure because it's between segments, as are the intersegmental arteries. These are arteries that come off the aorta in the developing embryo. But the spinal nerves, which will emerge from the spinal cord and leave the vertebral column, are segmental. So they're between vertebral bodies. This will make sense because if you look at the final picture, the spinal nerves emerge between vertebrae through that intervertebral foramen. And now we form most of the vertebral bodies and the intervertebral disc. This process of resegmentation results in muscles bridging vertebrae, which in turn helps them move the vertebral column. This was from mesenchymal condensation around the notochord. That forms the centrum, which is basically most of the vertebral body. Similarly, the mesenchyme around the neural tube is going to form the vertebral arch. But at this point, it's just called the neural arch. Again, if you look at the final picture, it'll make sense because the vertebral arch is around the vertebral foramen, which has the spinal cord. The primordium of the spinal cord is the neural tube. The mesenchyme from the body wall forms the costal elements, which in the thoracic region will form ribs. So now we have something that sort of looks like a vertebra, and it develops centers of chondrification, becoming cartilage. The spinous process and the transverse processes form by extensions of the chondrification centers in the neural arch. So from a mesenchymal vertebral column, we now have a cartilaginous column. And from cartilage, we got to form bone. That's with ossification centers. The primary ossification centers are three in number, one for the centrum and one each for the neural arches, so one on either side. Once they fuse, that leaves some parts with cartilage, like the spinous process. And in between the centrum and the neural arch is a cartilaginous neurocentral joint. With growth, the spinal cord grows, and this joint allows the vertebra to grow along with it. The vertebral body is actually formed mostly by the centrum, but the posterolateral bits are from the neural arch. That's because they fuse at that neurocentral joint, creating the neurocentral line. The bony halves of the vertebral arch also fuse. If they don't, and it's just the bone that hasn't fused, the spinal cord is intact. That is called spina bifida occulta, or a cleft vertebra, where only the bony part hasn't fused. The secondary ossification centers appear at puberty, and they are five in number. One for the tip of the spinous process, one each for the tips of the transverse processes, and two annular epiphyses. If we look at it from the side, that's the tip of the transverse process, the tip of the spinous process, and the two annular epiphyses, one above and one below. These are superior and inferior to the vertebral body, and when they fuse with the body, that creates the smooth rim. So the smooth rim is from the annular epiphysis. And we add that to the list of the structures that form the vertebral body. Once all these centers fuse, we've got a complete vertebra. But we're not done. We've just got a little bit left. Not all vertebrae look the same. Cervical, thoracic, lumbar, for example. Now we know that the centrum forms most of the vertebral bodies, and the rest is by the neural arches. But there were three parts, remember? What about those costal elements? In the thoracic region, they're going to form ribs, but all the vertebrae have costal elements. They don't usually have ribs, but they have costal elements. That fuses with the transverse process, like in cervical vertebrae, which have that foramen transversarium. We've got the transverse process and the costal process forming the boundaries of it. In the lumbar vertebrae, it also fuses with the transverse process. In the sacral vertebrae, it forms part of the anterior ala. So things differ in different parts of the column. Like a striking difference would be with the first two, atlas and axis. They look completely different than the others. The centrum of atlas fuses with axis, and that forms the dens. So there's no vertebral body for atlas, and what remains of the centrum just forms the anterior arch. Axis, however, has two of them. One centrum forms the body fused with the centrum of atlas that forms the dens. And thus between the two, there's no intervertebral disc. But that's how vertebrae develop, and together they form the vertebral column. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.